Heading into last weekend, the 13th-ranked Statesmen football team was out to make history and a possible run in this year's NAIA playoffs. However, Penn's first roadblock was defending national champ Saint Xavier. CRI and OSP's Jason Madison made the trip to Chicago to see if an upset was on the horizon or if Goliath would crush David.
A clear, crisp, and cool afternoon in front of 3,000 was the setting for this showdown at Deaton Field. Penn was ready to show its worth on the road, especially since St. X was already looking past the Statesmen. On the Cougars' athletic website, the home team already had the first round game going in its favor. So, will the bold prediction hold true? We'll find out. We pick things up in the second quarter, Penn down 3-0 and on his 37. The handoff goes to fullback Evan Ressler, who nets 24 yards to give his team a spark. Unfortunately, on the next play, St. Xavier's Zach Dolph strips Sean Davis, and the Cougars take over on his 38-yard line, a little over 9 minutes to go. That's when St. Xavier's quarterback, Jimmy Coy, goes to work. Coy rolls out to the far side and finds wideout Sean Zachary on the sideline. Zachary keeps 1 foot in for the 19-yard gain. One play later, Coy goes back to Zachary, who's wide open on this 23-yard grab in the end zone, sending the home team up 10-0. Then Penn is forced to punt on his own 38. Nevertheless, WPU decides to go with a fake punt run and is snuffed out by St. X. Turnover on downs with 6 minutes to go before halftime. On the ensuing drive, the Cougars go back to the air. This time, Coy's 35-yard bomb hits Corey Winnemaka, and just like that, it's 17-0. Now, with only 45 seconds left in the half, Penn must punt from the 17. And this time, the snap sails over the hands of Jason Johnson and out of the end zone, giving St. Xavier 2 points on the safety. The half ends with Penn down 19-0, and it didn't get any prettier from there. St. Xavier would go on to score 2 more times in the second half, including a 66-yard pick six with less than 2 minutes left in regulation. In the playoff game, the Cougars' defense was stout, holding the nation's third-best rushing offense to a season-low 100 yards. The home team also exploited Penn's secondary most of the game, racking up 336 yards and 2 scores. The Cougars simply outplayed the Statesmen in most phases of the game, except special teams. William Penn blocked 4 kicks on the day, 2 extra points, 1 field goal, and 1 punt. Penn has now been shut out in both trips to the postseason. The first came in 1975 against California Lutheran, when the Navy and Gold fell 27-0. For CRI Weekly News, I'm Jason Madison.